Hello and welcome to another episode of 7 Days to Die. If anything in this video is helpful to you or you enjoy the video, give it a thumbs up and click that subscribe button. It helps me a lot and it keeps me passionate to continue going on and doing these videos. Let's get into this.
Nothing. So, yeah, I think...
Because I swear it used to be earlier than seven. It was never. It's yeah. Never going to be eight, is it?
No. That's two. You know.
Let's just go then. It looks light outside. It looks actually pretty. It looks nice outside, but that noise just hasn't. Yeah, we need to. Now we're gonna. What we're doing now then? We're outside. We're scavenging, and we're trying to find a. Are we trying to find a new place to live, or we're gonna be living here for a bit?
I think that I don't know. if you want, I can go and follow the path and see where it leads to. See if I can find a better play.
Yeah, if you want.
Yeah, what I am going to do is craft a bedroll and stick it in here just in case I am the first one to die. I know I don't have much confidence in myself, but, just in case.
If you die, you die. Don't worry about it. How many more do I need? So how much more of the fiber do I need? So I need 1, 2...
Right, okay.
How long do they take to make? They take about 20 seconds.
What's that?
So I'm coming back in the house. The bed rolls.
Okay. Yeah, I've just put mine down upstairs.
Upstairs?
Yeah.
Might as well put them upstairs then.
Oh, yeah. It also took us a long time to find this out, but if you hold down your X button, you can quickly select your map, your crafting.
Yeah, you can select which one you want.
Yeah, I totally forgot about that.
I did as well, actually. I completely forgot that was a thing.
We knew that, and we still forgot it was a thing, so...
Yeah, I know. Yeah. I was sitting there thinking, I know there's an easier way to do this.
It's fine, we're all good. Now I've got some stone. I'm going to make myself a load of arrows, because they stack, and they make really quickly, so...
Right, I'm at the path. Shall I go up or shall I go down? Up is
down.
Good, isn't it?
Up. Right, go up then.
Go up, yeah.
Up. You said up. You said up was good. Up.
Well, I can't imagine going down would be good.
No, this is the thing that happens. You get scared shitless by the people you're in the party with. I'm just shit myself seeing Andy thinking I've got to have a fight now with a random zombie.
You're an idiot.
And it was Andy. So, yeah.
Although I went up and now I'm going down, so I don't think it would make any difference.
Sneeze.
Sorry about sneezing.
Corn seeds.
Also found another zombie.
She found another Zambambo.
Yeah. Just whacked her with my club.
Ooh, or pig.
Oh, I found
pigs.
I
think pigs are like fucking extremely hard to kill in this game.
They are, but they're bloody.
If you run after them,
yeah,
they will just
they're
ridiculously fast. Maybe I got a better club.
Any rotten flesh or any meat.
Okay,
that you have to attract zombies.
So How it works is if you've got arrows, and to start off with, when you pull your bow out, you can't use any arrows, but I have because I've just accidentally fucking done it without telling you what to do. But you pull your... If I drop my arrows and pick them back up again, I take them back off my finger so I can show them what it looks like. I pick them back up again. Okay, so this is what your thing will look like at start off of. It's like saying that there's no arrows in it and you can't shoot it. It's really weird because we were trying to figure it out for quite a while. But when she said hold X and you get this inventory bar thing where you can pick whether crafting or players or anything, if you hold B, it brings up all the arrows that you can make. And the one that's got the number on it, which says 44 at the top, that's coloured in. That means you can, now they're on my, now I can use the arrows. And now whenever I swap to the, if I have the arrows on me, no matter where I have them in my inventory, if I have them on me, and I, move into the thing, it just automatically spawns them straight in, so you don't have to worry about constantly doing that every time you pull your bow and arrow out. Oh, dude, I don't know what to get now. What am I low on? Everything.
Yep. You're affected by something, can't you?
I am affected by something. Thanks for reminding me about that, Andy. So if you ever get hurt or you ever overheated or anything like that, if you click on your character info, it's literally at the top. It will tell you all the, at the bottom right, it tells you all the things you're infected by. So I'll say, like, overheated,
guess what I just found.
Weathered. What did you find, Andy?
I found some potato seeds.
Okay, so it takes us 3 days to find potato seeds on our first, on our game, but as soon as we do it now, instantly, like, an hour in, day two.
Oh, shit.
And yeah, if at the bottom right here, it'll tell you if you're overheated, infected, hungry, fucking thirsty, anything like that.
You're going to be the first to buzz and to die.
That I am going to die.
And if you click on the thing you want to do, so see it says infected here, it's highlighted.
Oh, no, no.
It tells you how long you're going to be infected for. So I'm going to be infected for an hour, 45 minutes and 40 seconds.
Ouch.
And it tells you down here how to get rid of them. So it's either herbal antibiotics or a jar of honey.
Yeah, I'm dying, guys, and I don't know what
all
to
I've got
do.
Is beer. So Lisa is dying, apparently.
A log cabin. Yeah.
And when you put a bedroll in, if you look on my map at the top where it says south, north, and all that shit, there's a bed symbol, which means I'm will spawn at that location.
Oh, your connection to the internet has removed this issue. Try again later.
Andy's been disconnected. Yeah.
Oh, no.
You still in chat, Andy? Because I can't hear you. Can you still hear him, Lisa? No, so he's been completely disconnected.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's happened. So, I tried to have a look because there's these things called Golden Duke Casino Coins. A Duke Casino Coin, after enterprising the war, become the main currency to trade. So it says trading, but we've never found anyone. I don't know if there is other people that you can possibly find. Because I think there might be NPCs.
Yeah, you can do that.
I think there might be other NPCs because
there is.
If you ever get a note, it says we've been watching you, and if you do this, we can find out if we can trust you and shit like this. But we've never actually succeedly done one of them scenarios. So if we do one of them scenarios, if we find one of them notes, we'll do one of them scenarios, and we'll tell you if there's actually NPCs, because I actually don't know if that's what that means, or if it's just something to say and do this quest and you'll get some random shit like an airdrop or something.
I have seen a video of someone and they were talking to.
Oh, there you go. So there are NPCs.
A random person behind a
So the thing at the top right.
Right, where I am right now.
Go on.
Sorry. There is It's like an abandoned town. There's not much around, but there is this like supermarket.
She's found a supermarket
place around here, which I'm in.
Oh, that's cool.
At the moment. So if you want to show them how to market down on your map.
Oh yeah, I'll show them how to market down. Good idea. So how to market down your map is Lisa, as you can see just here, is on a supermarket, as she says, because I can't see she's in the supermarket because I ain't got that place on my map yet, because I haven't walked to where she is. But
I think it's
Y you click?
Can you survive
in
about 7 days, please?
Yes. So it's, save waypoint, is that right?
Is it Y?
So, I'm just, give me 1 second, I'm just going to invite Andy back to the game. I've invited him.
I can do it if you want.
And party, give me a second. This is brilliant. No, go on. Okay, so, back to the map. You click Y, you click save waypoint.
So sorry about all of that fucking about.
And there's a bunch of options you can pick. You can either have an X, which I think is X max a spot, so it's like treasure. You got like a convenience store, you got a little house, a little like double house symbol, you got a house. You got like a, it looks like a, what do you call that, like pillars and shit. Got a castle, like a city symbol. Campfire, another house symbol, and a cave symbol. So I'm gonna give it the little convenience store symbol. And then on the top of the map over here, over there, for when I get closer to it, you'll see it on the left hand side of my map here. I'm 605.7 meters away from the what is convenience store where Lisa is. So that constantly sticks on there now, so I will have that on my map permanently.
Yeah, Andy, if you want to put that on your map as well. I'm in a store.
I think I've shared it with everyone. Have I shared it with everyone?
Andy, I found a wrench.
Oh, fantastic.
For you.
So, what happens if you share it is if I find something really cool and I put it on the map just there, if I share it with the people who are in my. You can either share it with because everyone. So that'll be anyone who's on the map, either like allies or just friends, which I've just set it to friends because there's no point saying it to everyone because they're the only people in the server. And everyone gets the way marker now, so we're never going to miss it. And Lisa just said she found a wrench, which means that Andy can walk around now and use it on cars. And you get springs from them cars, and you also have a chance of getting an engine if you use the wrench on a car. And the engines are good later in the game for stuff like cement mixers and mini bikes. We haven't had mini bikes yet. We've seen people have mini bikes. We've never had them. And we will make mini bikes this game, trust me, but I will make them. I will come a time. It won't be soon, yes. It will be very late in the game, but I will make mini bikes. It will happen.
Sorry, I'm just happy I found
some water. That's good.
I was literally dying of thirst. No, I found some water.
Oh,
not
brilliant.
A source
okay,
of
that's,
water.
That's worse.
I'm working on the water.
When we find a source of water and we get ourselves a bucket, I'll show you guys how to pretty much make an infinite source of water. It's a cool little trick that you might not know. If you die in a thirst and you have to walk like 700 miles, it makes a difference.
I found loads of spam.
Spam's food. Spam works. The log cabin. I'm coming in the log cabin.
Makes you very thirsty.
It makes you thirsty.
Does anybody actually like spam on our island or not?
Yeah.
Yeah, I like spam. Spam's nice.
You don't like spam,
no.
Aaron?
No.
Okay.
No.
What?
You know where you guys are
yes.
right
yeah.
this second? Is that where where
yeah,
that's where
Andy's at the log cabin right now, yeah.
The only problem
you're
about the log cabin is the fact that it's all on the floor.
Yeah, so I'll explain. So this guy's got glasses and oil on him, which is pretty cool. But then after you've bought it, it like smashes up into these pieces. Wait, it's completely fucking... Okay, that's
disintegrated.
Yeah.
Sometimes they're completely disintegrated. Sometimes
but if they don't, they'll turn into a little like... It's like half a corpse
like
kind
a
of thing.
Yeah,
like
sometimes.
This.
Yeah, yeah.
And then if you hit it,
some more, yeah.
you then will get meat. And then if you hit it again, you'll then get a bone. Now, the meat is really bad, so you kind of want to lob that meat. Just chuck it away, because... It will like, it's like a scent thing, so all the zombies will run around and try and come and get it off you. And
you'll
have
a
nose
above
the,
your health.
Where the food is now on
your...
my screen, you'll have a little nose saying that you're.
That's
you
what
are,
I've
you
got
have
at
something
the moment,
on you that
I'm
is going to
food.
Make the zombies run after you and want to kill you. But yeah, this is what I mean. The bone shiv is really good because. You can, and it's actually, I looked it up as a weapon when I had one last. It's actually really good as a weapon. So it's always good to just, even if you've got just one shiv and you don't need it to do that thing at the moment, just make it into a bone shiv. It's not going to hurt you. It only takes a couple of seconds and it's actually like, really good as a, 3 point, because an axe does 2.7. But the shiv does 3.75, so it's actually really good as a little weapon. It's really quick as well. It's quicker than the axe.
I've got quite.
But still,
a
the best
of,
weapon that we have at the moment is has to be the bow and arrow because you can hit them from far distance before they even get close to you. And you can have the lucky shots that you get sometimes where you just aim and you shoot and the head just explodes. Because you've took the head off.
So, are we moving to...
The city that you're in. Yeah, you got backed out, Andy, but she found like a little city area.
But it's not worth living. You can't live in it. There's not much around here. It's literally just broken down buildings. Like, there is some buildings around here that... I've got shit in. I wouldn't live around him. Are we going to the place where Andy's found, or
was there anything much in the log cabin, Andy?
I'll be honest with you. Not only was there not a lot, there was not a lot of anything.
Apart from potatoes, dude.
That was you that found.
No, that wasn't
oh, shit,
actually
I'm not gonna fight him.
In the log cabin. That was, I found them in some trash on the way to the log cabin.
So,
Yeah, I've just come across some fat security guard zombie and I'm not even
going
to...
I'm going back in the house because I... Has anyone got any water?
I ain't got shit.
No, I've got one water.
I'm going to make a furnace then. Because I have one piece of water and I can. Oh wait, can I?
I've got some walls that need to be boiled down.
So you make you make a campfire, which looks like this. You put it somewhere. Bam.
Oh, hang on. I think I found.
When you go into it, you get your water here, which you make, which goes to there and then goes into the output section. Before you can make it, oh shit.
What?
Requires a cooking pot.
Yeah,
yeah,
you find
I
them
completely
in
forgot
kitchen.
About it needing the.
Can't you craft a cooking
can
pot?
Can you? Yes, you can, but you need a forge.
I think you can.
Yeah.
I'll buy it.
The forge is in exactly the easiest thing to make. Yeah, just fixing up this.
Oh crap.
But as I was saying, before you before you can make anything, you've got to put some you got to put a bit of wood in the side here, and that'll tell you on the right ten. I've got 10 seconds worth of fuel. You turn it on, you can see it fire. I like the effects of the fire on this game; they're pretty nice. But yeah, it has to be on before you can cook anything. But if you walk over it like I have done a couple of times before, you will set yourself on fire. Which isn't the best of ideas.
Oh, I'm not going to lie, I just shat myself, guys. The water supply, on the other hand, is not very easy to get to.
Okay.
And I kind of fell into it and almost drowned myself.
Brilliant. At least we know to go straight to that water supply.
But it's fine.
Are you
it's
back out fine. Yet?
Yep, I'm out. Good. It's absolutely fine.
So what do I need? I need some more stone and some more fiber. So I'll get the stone first because it's gonna take the biggest piss take.
Fuck off! You can't even reach me from there. Oh, these zombies! It's like they've got monkey arms.
Stamina +10, but hydration -1. This is not good for me now. So I've eaten.
How do we make a bucket?
Furnace. I think it's the forge again. Because you need a forged iron, I think.
Okay.
So yeah, I'm thirsty, and I think, even though I made the rule up, might be the first one to die.
What?
So yeah.
If you do die, it's not a massive thing. You spawn.
I'm gonna try. If I can see myself dying, I'm really close to the house. If I can see myself dying, I'm gonna walk to the house as close as I possibly can before I do die. But as you can see, I got myself 5 more points earlier, if you see, and I'm going to put them back on my toolsmithing. There you go. So I've spent them all on my toolsmithing.
Right, I found a toilet. I'm going to smash it to get the pipe.
You need to smash the toilets. Remember the smashing of the toilets.
Yeah, the best thing to do with the toilet is to use a wrench on them.
There you go. That's another hint I didn't know.
Because you get a lot more off when you use a wrench off them.
You get a lot more parts if you use a wrench. There you go.
Okay. Well, I did not know that. Thank you for that, Andy.
That's fine. It's only day of the week.
I haven't seen that symbol before. Above my nose, I shit you not, there is a picture of a bum and a piece of poo underneath it. I think this means I'm shitting.
Have a look. Have a look on your set on the thing. If you go to your little character, your little man, the character section, on the right hand side, it'll give you all the things that you're doing that are above your name. Yeah.
All the pictures.
Right at the bottom right, after you go to your character. You see that?
It
should say at the top.
I don't even know what that is.
After you've clicked on it, it should tell you at the top.
Hang on, I'm going to get back to you. Hang on a sec.
Tools, stone axe.
I'm really bad because I can't spell. So, not spell, I can't read properly. It's a big word.
I am not the best reader, so I'm not going to read.
The player's statue.
No, you won't be able to see, Andy. Because you have to have that ability. You have to have that ability to be able to read the.
Oh, let me get to you guys and I'll spell it out.
Send a picture.
Why don't you message me on
to this
Facebook?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Now I've got to try and run up this massive hill. With no stamina. to get back to you. And I've got to collect some more stone.
So I've got stone, I've got wood. I need some more wood and I need some more fibre, so that's... What's next on my list? Wood and fibre.
I think I found beer, or is that honey?
Yeah, they look so close.
I'm not sure. Beer and honey, they look
so
similar.
Yeah, I was sitting there going, because I've got, I'm infected. And one of the things to get infection off is a pot of honey. And I was sitting there, and I've got beer on me as well, and I was like, oh, shit, I've got honey on me. I could just get rid of the infection. I've read it, it's got this beer. I was like, bastard.
You drank beer?
No, I didn't drink it. I just thought it was, and I looked at it and found out that it was beer. Oh, I was like, you're mad.
I was going to say, beer fixes everything. What are you talking about?
No, it doesn't. Don't talk about it. No one does alcohol. We're too young, joking. No. I can't even lie about that one.
You were drinking last
night? I actually was, yeah.
He likes to get drunk.
Every now and then.
He's a bit
I'm
of
not.
An
I don't bring life. This. Don't do this. Don't be doing this. But I was drinking with the person who I don't know when this video is going to go out, so. But I was drinking with the person who will be doing the Skyrim videos for this channel. So yeah. Whenever that Skyrim comes out, him, that's who I was drinking with.
So are we staying at this place that we were at before?
So
I need to empty
at least
my
another night or two, just so we can kind of.
Yeah, because it's only day two, and it's nothing bad's
really
gonna happen.
Yeah. We'll definitely move away. I'm definitely interested in moving out myself. But
now,
I just don't think we should rush it.
The thing I want to let everyone know about, just in case you think, because I don't know why I had this feeling when we bought this game, but the game's called 7 Days to Die, as you all know, because we've been playing it. But I always had this feeling that it's 7 days, the game would end. That'd be it. At 7 days, you only had 7 days in the game, and then after day seven, you'd start back at level one. You'd start back at day one again. But it doesn't happen. Every day after seven just gets so hard. It's ridiculously fucking stupid how hard it gets after seven. And wait until we get to seven. If you haven't seen this game before, wait until we get to seven and you'll see how difficult this game gets. It gets quite difficult on seven. Because they swarm you.
On the seventh day, your best bet is to go upstairs
and block ourselves
in. Block yourself in.
Last time we did it, Lisa built us like a little wooden iron cabinet thing. And he's got a problem, he's face to face with two.
Oh, yeah, up off the ground.
Wait, are you near me?
Yeah, ish.
Oh, yeah, I can see ya. Another one?
No, they're all dead now.
Good man.
I don't have anything interesting running me up and leaving.
The nurses normally
carry
doctor things, like things to medicate. So that's pretty useful. So if you see any nurses,
I think it's telling me that I'm constipated. Sorry, the picture is telling me. I think because it's lasting about another 30 minutes.
No, that's just. Is there anything that could stop that? Because there normally is things on the game. There probably is something on the game.
No. No, it just tells me that I'm carrying food and that it's going to attract attention. So
I think she might have put a picture in the chat, Andy, for you. But yeah.
Dysentery.
What does that mean?
It's not necessarily great. You don't want dysentery. It's an illness.
Yeah, I get that, but
it's basically like having it's basically like having the runs.
So I've basically got diarrhea. Right.
You got diarrhea while trying to run away from zombies. I get what's happened. You've seen one of them little girl zombies. Then you've literally shit yourself instead of saying that you've literally it's happened in game. Timber.
Do you think it's safe for me to go wandering around and looking for a house? Or shall I just stick around here and
wait
until
you stop shooting yourself? I don't know.
That's really good.
I thought that's what you were going to say. I thought I would try and finish the conversation before you... I need some more stone. I've got enough fiber.
I need stone. I need a lot of... I've got wood, I just need stone.
No, I just put myself quite a bit of fibre and some wood, so I just need my stone. I am now starving and thirsty. So, I hope this rule that I brought in about the thing that
we
popped up saying first death him, I hope that isn't me. If I am first death, I might just skip out and pretend it weren't me.
You dickhead.
Yeah, that time's happening, guys. My health is slowly going down because I'm too thirsty.
And literally, there is nothing you can do about it.
So
trim,
start heading my way home. Which I'm doing now. Now the thing about being thirsty, which I hate, is you can't run because your thirst is technically your stamina. So every time you get hurt from being thirsty, your stamina literally goes down to nothing. So you can't do anything besides from literally just wait for yourself to die.
Jump on the inside of a house, have you noticed? You sort of drop kick weirdly.
If you what? Yeah, because you'd hitting your head off the roof. That's what you're doing, you're hitting your head off the roof.
That's hilarious. You jump then. And you kind of swivel to one side, it's kind of hilarious.
This is how I say goodbye. In 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Chris died first.
The shittest way you could ever die.
Oh, that's great. That takes the stress off everyone else.
Brilliant.
Let's just write that down. C and then C.
No ridiculous.
Just make it. I'm just writing it down so that I can remember to pretty much call myself and just do something in the video. No. Whoa, brilliant. Wait. What was this last time? this happened to one of us last time. How did we sort it out?
What?
I can't move.
Oh, what, you glitched in somewhere?
I don't know.
Route?
No, there was a way, because there was once where I think it was Andy that got out of bed.
No, I don't know. I'm not
and
sure.
And he was stuck, and I didn't... And he, can you remember?
Did you put it down in that area where we had it last
No, it was up, it's up in the roof, because it was in the kitchen last time.
Andy?
Yep.
Come upstairs and like, try and break my bed or something.
Okay. Say so.
Because I can't move.
You move now?
No. Great video.
You're not touching anyone else's bed though, so. How hard is it to make a bed?
Then you're 25er. At least he's breaking your bed. That just still doesn't work.
No, it's gone. It's fine.
Breaking a block underneath you would work. Hitting you would work.
I got friendly fire off. So you can't hit me.
It's okay to jump.
You might have to leave.
But it's my server.
Back.
No, mm. Well, this. Yes.
Are you upstairs?
Well, you're all not.
No,
are
I'm standing
crouching?
Up.
Can you crouch?
Can you?
Can't do anything.
You can't do shit.
Jump.
I can't. It literally, when I say I can't do anything, I mean I can't do anything. Give me a second.
So you can't swing, you can't do nothing.
It might have been his controller that went fucked up. Yeah, it was his controller.
Disconnecting my controller and it worked.
That was what it was before, wasn't it?
Yeah, I remember there being something. I remember there being something that I had to do. And we've now figured it out. I'm glad we figured it out, but now we've just ruined two beds.
Yeah, you need to sort them out.
Are you dick?
Don't be blaming me. I'm not a freak.
It's fine.
Oi.
It doesn't take that much.
Don't be calling me a freak.
Once you've made him one, you can make me one as well, please.
What?
A bed. I need a bed.
Make your own bed, lazy bastard.
You make my bed for me, you freak.
Huh?
Aww. Oh, your words hurt, Andy.
They do, don't they, Lisa?
He's a sensitive soul.
Yeah, I know.
He's got to be
nice. He's not sensitive.
He's extremely sensitive.
Thank you.
It's alright, Chris. You're not afraid.
Thank you.
It's fine.
That laugh there confirms everything I need to know.
Yeah, that's good enough, isn't it?
I need to know nothing else besides from. Ha 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 ha! So what time did you, can you actually remember what time it is? Because we left it a little bit too late, I think, today. When we went to that. I think it's like 5 in the morning, isn't it?
I think it is 5 in the morning, you know.
Yeah. So when it gets to 5 in the morning, we need to listen out, because.
Okay.
I've got a strong feeling it's 5 in the morning as well, you know.
We really need to find that flipping kitchen.
We definitely do.
I was just come back online. Is he, Yeah.
Is he what?
He's on me.
Fucking axe.
What?
Getting more stone.
I need loads of stone.
Get some more fiber after this.
You really need a pickaxe.
Really do, but to make the basic pickaxe, you need a foundry, don't you? A forge.
See, a foundry? Fucking hell.
Shut up.
An iron pickaxe, that would be forged iron. So can we actually make a forge? What do we have?
We need
quite a lot of
one. I think we need like 20 animal hide.
Yeah, yes we do.
And
and there's no point in putting the forge down in a place where we're not going to stay, because unfortunately, guys, you can't pick it up.
As soon as you make the forge and put it down, you're fucked.
That's where you are. I say I'm gonna come in now because I can't run. I've got no Yeah.
It's 21, so that means we've got like how long? Like half an hour.
Like 40 minutes. Well, I'm already upstairs, so
I'm heading upstairs now as well. When it gets to the right time in the morning where we can stop, we'll stop there. Then we'll have a few days break, we can think about what the fuck we're going to be doing next time we come on.
So
pretty much what you do during this night is exactly what you did last night.
Yep. It's every night.
Craft your axes and then craft some weapons to rank everything up. First thing I'm going to do is lob all my weapons and shit on the floor besides from my stone, my bone shiv. To get rid of all the old shit.
Oh, yeah.
You're right there.
And now I need... What are you crafting now? I ain't crafting until dead on 10 o'clock. Is it?
I'm just getting rid of all my shit.
How many fucking shit did you have?
I had loads. Oh, Andy, here. Come here.
I'm here.
Where are you?
I'm here, that helps. Original.
Yeah, that's really good.
So let me down.
There you go.
Oh, fantastic.
Ready. Bye. Wow, I can make a hell of a lot. I can make 200 and...
Yeah, they make trees.
They make a lot of trees. I've got 4 pine cones on me, so... So, yes... Crafting. Okay, well. Yeah, as Lisa was saying, if you cover over the knot of the 9 that's on my screen now, click A on it, and then you can put whatever number you want in. So you don't have to be, sitting there fucking about thinking what number you need and clicking up constantly. You just press a number in. But it's best for me to do that, so I have to keep clicking on. There you go. Is being crafted.
Well, if this is all we're doing, you could probably like end the recording now.
So we're just going to be doing this for the rest of the night, doing making axes, making maybe some bats, maybe some arrows, whatever, and we will be back during day 3 to start the morning again. Okay, bye. Yeah.
Bye.
Thanks for watching 7 Days to Die. If you want us to do anything in the next couple of episodes, put it in the comments. If you found anything interesting, press the like button, click subscribe. Bye.